This question is about interference between two waves. Two overlapping waves of the same type travel in the same direction. The variation with distance x of the displacement y of each wave is shown in this figure 6.1. The speed of the waves is 240 meters per second. The waves are coherent and produce an interference pattern. Explain the meaning of coherence and interference. Two waves are coherent when the path difference between them is constant. Path difference constant means both waves have the same frequency and wavelength. Interference is the superposition of coherent waves, which means both waves have the same frequency and wavelength. Superposition means when two or more waves overlap and produce a resultant wave. The second part is a practical question. Use the figure 6.1, which is the graph, to determine the frequency of the waves. I'm going to color code each wave, one pink and one green. The size of the wavelength of the pink one starts here and ends right here. To read with accuracy, I need to identify how much is each small tile. So here I have from 0 to this is 5, from here to here is 10. So 0.5 meter corresponds to 10 small boxes. So 0.5 meter corresponds to 10 boxes. So each box will be 0.5 divided by 10 is 0.05 meter per box. Okay, so this is 3. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4 boxes. Each box is 0.05 meter times 4 is 0.2. So I will read this 3.2 meter. Both waves, the pink and the green, have the same wavelength. So here is the pink wavelength, which is 3.2 meter. To find the wavelength of the green one, we can start right here, backwards. So it should be right here. So it's from here to here. So if this is 1, and I have 1, 2, 3, 4 boxes, so this one must be 0.8. So the wavelength of the green one is 4 minus 0.8, which is 3.2. The X label is in meter. So to find the frequency, I need the wave equation, which is from this triangle, V lambda F. So my F is V over lambda. The velocity of both waves is 240 meters per second. So here is 240 meters per second. The wavelength is 3.2 meters. So the frequency is 75 hertz. So both waves have the same frequency and same wavelength because they are coherent. So what is the corresponded phase difference, which means in degrees? Remember this graph? One complete wavelength is equal to 360 degrees. So one complete wavelength, which is 3.2 meters, is equal to 360 degrees. The horizontal difference between the pink and the green wave can be determined by these two values right here. So here is, you have two little tiles. Each one is 0.05 meter, so that will be 1. So right here is 1.6. And here is, we did before, is 0.8. So So 1.6 minus 0.8 is 0.8 meter. What about this one? So this is, we determined before, this is 3.2. And now we need to find how much is this intersection right here. So this is 2.4. 3.2 minus 2.4 is 0.8. So this is the path difference. It's constant. So now my path difference is 0.8 meter. And what will be the correspondent in degrees? So 4 is equal to 360. And my phase difference. I don't know if I mess up with the terms. I'm doing now phase difference. Phase difference is in degrees. Path difference is in length. I'm converting now the path difference into phase difference. So that will be 360 divided by 4. So this is 90 degrees. So my phase difference is 90 degrees. Last part of this problem. Use the principle of superposition to sketch on figure 6.1 the resultant wave. Like I mentioned before, the principle of superposition occurs when two or more waves meet at a point and the resultant wave is the sum of the vertical displacement of the individual waves. Let me start with these points here, 0 and 2. I'm going to add 0 plus 2 is 2. What about here? So the correspondent here, this intersection is 1.5. So the pink wave, the vertical displacement is at 1.5. And the green wave is also 1.5. So I'm going to add 1.5 plus 1.5, that is 3. Then I mark right here at 3. Next, the green wave is at 0 and the pink wave is at 2. So now when I add 0 plus 2 is 2. Now moving in this direction, so now I have positive 1.5 and negative 1.5. So when you add both, that will be 0. So right here as 0. Now in this intersection for the green and the pink, both are at negative 1.5. So when we add both, it will be negative 3. So the next stop is right here when the green wave is 0 at 0 and the pink one is negative 2. So 0 and negative 2 is negative 2. And then my next stop is right here. So when my pink is positive, I'm sorry, my green one is positive 1.5 and my pink one is negative 1.5. When you add, that will be 0. And my next stop will be right here. So my pink one at 0, my green one is at 2, so then you'll be right here. Let me mark this, didn't do that. And right here, where we see this intersection, both are positive 1.5 when you add them, and that will be 3. And my last one is this one with positive 2 and this is 0, so that will be my next point. So as you see, not difficult at all. You just need to identify some points on this graph. The question is asking a sketch, not to be perfect. And you just need to add the vertical displacement when both waves intersect at the same point. So you add and you start to mark points. So you have here 1, 2, 3, Next one here. Days, 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 days. And now I'm going to connect all those points. And that will be my resultant wave. So I'm doing this blue color. So the shape should be about the same shape of both waves, the pink and the green. So I apply the principle of superposition to obtain my blue wave, which is the result of the pink and the green wave overlapping as they travel at the same direction.